Hi, let's talk a little bit about your lungs. And I have for you here a complete set of right and left lungs as well as the heart. Now, if you recall, the right lung typically has three lobes. There's a superior lobe, a small middle lobe, and quite a large inferior lobe. The inferior lobe is separated from the other lobes by this oblique fissure, whereas the middle lobe is separated from the superior lobe by the horizontal fissure. On the left side, things are a little more simple with respect to the lobes. We have a superior lobe and an inferior lobe separated by an oblique fissure. We also have a cardiac notch, which gives the heart a little room to operate, as well as a lingula, which is the tongue of the lung here. Now, what you may notice about the overall coloration of this individual's lungs is that there are distinct regions that are very dark and sooty, and then there are other regions that are very light. Now, we see this very commonly in the gross anatomy labs, and if you look at some of these accompanying specimens here, you'll notice that there's quite a wide range of variation of color with respect to these specimens. But overall, they're fairly blotchy and dark. This is fairly well representative of what we see in longtime smokers' lungs. You see the tar and the other impurities that have made it to the respiratory bronchioles and the alveoli along the surface of the parenchyma of the lungs. In addition, one thing that I'd like to show you on the posterior aspect of the lungs is to give you a true appreciation of the three-dimensionality of the lobes of the lungs. So for instance, that inferior lobe of the lung extends nearly all of the way up to probably within a few fingers' breadths of the apex of each lung. So posteriorly, that inferior lobe rides very high. So we've talked a little bit about the lungs, where they're located, their lobes and fissures, and the three-dimensionality of where the lobes occupy space. Thank you.